So we look at it, and that tells us how much time we have. But every now and then, the numbers change. We should point somebody out. There's a gentleman sitting right there in the middle of the room with glasses on. That's Aaron. Everybody say, hi, Aaron.
Hi, Aaron.
He is the one running the show. Like, he's the one in charge. He's telling us what to do. Like, he's the one that's like, oh, man, time to open the doors. Like, play the music. And I'm like, okay. And I just wanted to totally point him out and embarrass him because he not only is in charge of the show, but he has the best seat in the entire house because it's elevated up over everybody's heads. So,
you know, speaking of best seats, these guys just came up. Let's give them a round of applause. What we do for our fans, if you come to this room, you come to our panel, we have what's called the best seats in the house. We go to the back of the line, people that are going to get the nosebleed seats, and we pick 10 people to come and have a seat here on stage. Best seats in the house. That's because we love the fans, right? Could be you. Also, we have a great sponsor. Toys R Us is sponsoring us. Thank you, Toys R Us. And we all love toys, right? So right now, let's take a look at a little commercial from our sponsor.
Careful there, little guy.
Whoa.
They thought it would be good, so we cut that. All right,
pushes them out windows.
Do I have any more? I got, I think I got two more shirts. That's not my way over there. Is there a sign I haven't been to?
I would say at the back section up there, but I don't
think
that's
the back section over here.
We remember what happened this morning.
I remember what happened this morning. So I'm coming to the back. Time? You guys love C-3PO? You all right with by James Arnold Taylor. You guys enjoy the show!
Doing. What? Bigger? Okay. You want me to do one of my voices? Okay, hang on. I can't prepare for this. Let's try this again. Guys, maybe help me out here a little. Ladies and gentlemen, and Star Wars fans of all ages, it is with great pleasure that I direct your attention to the main stage to witness the vocal and physical manifestation of the world's most famous protocol droid. Please welcome Anthony Daniels! This is good. Okay. This is exciting. Huh? He knows what he's doing. Okay. Let me see. I think maybe a little more refined. What do you think, yes? We have a little music, maybe? Yes? Fine, beautiful people of Celebration Anaheim! Congratulations! You have proven your superior intelligence by selecting the number one show to see at Celebration! Prepare yourselves to witness a man among droids. A man who is the unmistakable voice of a droid. A man supremely qualified to be the ultimate droid physiotherapist because he's been inside the head of a droid for over 38 years! Man requests that all upstanding fans now stand up very good and clap and cheer until you appear to need medical attention. Please welcome the man inside the heart and chaos of C-3PO, the one, the only, Anthony!
Yeah.
So, we want to try something new with you. Are you up for the challenge?
I think you should be
very.
No.
No, here. I have 8 envelopes. And inside each is a topic and a task or a test. The 3 T's. Topic, task, or test. All you have to do is pick an envelope, and inside will reveal what we will talk about or discover about you. Are you ready to play? I'm going to lay them out here. 8 envelopes. Choose wisely, my friend.
This is why the price is right. I am very sorry.
Yes.
Okay. Will it be? Okay. Okay. What is your favorite number? 8.
You know what's funny? If it says 8 envelopes, there's only 7. No, we have 7 envelopes.
You don't get a second chance. You got it wrong.
Stupid. Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay, so down here.
Would you like to pick one?
Okay. Who can think of a number that's on the... Are you going to be sick? Okay. R2D, what is your favorite number? 2. 2 number 2. Is that okay? Number 4.
Number 4.
All right, what do I do with it?
I'll take it.
Well, that was very short. Did you enjoy it?
That's good.
Ladies and gentlemen, any other numbers over here?
Okay, here we go. Okay, Come on back. I'm going to read this.
Okay. Can I sit down?
Yes, please. Have a seat, sir. It's your stage. Commercial success is our title. So here we go. You've selected number 4, which is called commercial success. And these questions are about your many commercials. 3PO has been seen in countless commercials. First question. Do you, sir, have a favorite?
Well, you're right, there have been quite a few. One or two I dare to mention. So embarrassing, you know, the internet will come back to haunt you. I mean, there is one. Underwear. Underwear is not a dirty word. Actually, it's not 2 dirty words, if you see what I mean. What are you saying?
We could look at a little montage of some of these if you'd like.
Okay. No laughing, right?
Thousands are gathered to see the metallic megastars place their footprints and cement in the theater's courtyards. The world resounds with the fact that Star Wars itself has become a full-fledged social phenomenon.
Underwoods
are for earthlings. Oh, the shame.
children that were in those commercials right out here in college. It's
anything for money.
Let's go to another envelope. Shall we go to another envelope?
Okay.
All right. How do you want to choose this one?
Shall I choose myself?
Just go ahead and choose.
What is your favorite number?
What do we have before?
We have four,
so I'm going to choose...
Five. All right, sir, let me take a look inside.
Are you still all right? I'm sorry, I didn't ask your opinion last time because it didn't work very well, did it? Okay. So you just be quiet and watch it.
This one should be good. This is titled, Favorite or Worst? Or Worst? Favorite and worst. These questions are about some of your favorite and worst Star Wars related moments.
There have been so many.
And so, favorites. So let's start with number one. Favorite Star Wars location to film?
Location. Movies. The desert. Let's.
If you're wearing a 3PO suit and sand gets in there.
And I mean get in there everywhere, and you can't get in it and scratch or anything.
Oh,
it's not a happy moment. Are you going to take me back to those days?
No, let's move on to the next one then.
All right, I just tell the story. Did you see that? He was going to ask about itchy places, right?
Well, I thought this would lead in worst Star Wars location film.
Which Star Wars location? Well, I didn't go to Hoth because I really died. Are you taking me to Hoth?
No, you
are. Okay. I like the Redwood Forest. Apart from the Ewoks, obviously. No, I love the Ewoks. It's a myth that I...
They think you're some sort of...
They are. They think I am some sort of god, but they never asked my opinion of what I thought of them. It's too much. I mean, they're really kind of support. Come on.
Yes.
Okay, how about the favorite scene?
Favorite scene?
Favorite scene, actually, I was talking about it earlier today. Take your mind back, if you will. Can we have some Take Your Mind Back theme music? Okay. That's not Take Your Mind Back. It's disco. Okay. Imagine you're in the forest of Endor, surrounded by trees. And suddenly, out of the undergrowth, come these furry things. And yes, they see C-3PO as the true, his true wolf. Godliness on the planet, on the moon. They're deeply touched. And so later that night, having captured human beings who are worth nothing to Ewoks, who actually, now I come to think of it, are deeply sensitive and intelligent creatures, they arrange that particularly Han Solo, who has been rude to 3PO for about three stories so far, wait for it. They arrange for Han Solo to be hung over the log fire. At which point Han Solo says, 3PO, what are they jabbering about? It appears, Captain Solo, that you are to be the main course at a banquet given in my honor.
Favorite piece of C-3PO merchandise?
This is definitely a runner-up, but this is...
Did you see that?
Just for you.
Thank you. Okay, that was...
That was beautiful. That
worst
Star Wars C-3PO merchandise for you.
The worst C-3PO merchandise actually comes to me without any memory nudge at all. And we won't have mood music because it's... Has anybody ever seen the Scotch tape dispenser? For those who have never seen it, I will not
a demonstration.
I will not demonstrate. Okay. Imagine a ceramic thing about that big with 3PO in a sort of, how shall we say, interesting position. Some of you may know, in the studio, a studio as big as this, and the walls of whatever color you wanted to paint them. In this case, it's normally blue or green. But often you had a real floor, because it's just easier to make a real floor and have people stand on it. So we had a real floor. And all I had to do was to walk along, and I think Arthur was by my side, for a change, it's supposed to be digitally put in afterwards. And I'm walking along, and I'm walking to camera. Sorry, I'm going to start again. Wrong walk. Hey, I've got two, you know what I mean. Hey. So, I'm talking to this, whatever. And I walk past camera, because that's what I've been asked to do. So I then walk back this way. Normally, it's a different act. And they dress me up, and all I can do, Don Beans, you know, is to look after me, puts the head on, and I turn around, and I cock where the camera is, and they say, action! Now I'm looking this way, after blah, 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 blah. And suddenly, I begin to move in this direction. And I have, you know, you saw a breakfast cereal commercial earlier. I felt as if I was falling into a giant bowl of Kellogg's C-3POs. I mean, the crunch sound, I think I can help you with this.
Bye bye.
Oh, no.
See you later.
There
is Obi-Wan Kenobi. 3PO is quietly trotting off in the distance. Now as they're closer and they're talking very seriously, and suddenly, it was now doing the most amazing press up on the window not to dive over the car.
Unfortunately, they didn't realize that I couldn't see it. Or if they did realize I couldn't see it. Shall we try another at all? Let's try. That is so many. And you've got your names and people who laughed.
Would you like to try another envelope? One with better luck? Let's try another one then.
Huh? Okay, yeah, well, okay. And I'm just going to go for it. I'm going to go for number six.
Number six? Okay.
I'm looking here, okay?
Yeah.
I got the number thing back. Actually, it gets easier with the choice. Let's see. Right,
game's been shared on. You've selected number six. Explain this. I will show you something from your past, and you will need to explain this.
Oh. Very good, madam. It is C-3. One day on the set, it's before we meet. So Luke and the early one are going off to buy a thing, a spaceship thing. And I'm sitting by the side of the set, and they come up to me and say, "Hey, Tom, can you put on this costume, because you're not in this shot, and we've made this suit to your body. It's got white pointy face."
White and pointy face.
Yes, and as I looked at it, I thought, well, I can see why they call him white pointy face. You know, through English, it was very literal. And I put it on, and it was brilliant, because the chest is really much bigger than I am, so I could breathe. I could breathe, and it was great. And so, in the shot, as Obi-Wan and Luke come by, they pass this. You look at that face, you think, this guy's either very nervous or heavily medicated or on something. And he was medication. And so I thought he really is quite twitchy, because he's all a bit lost. And I was in that scene for about 10 seconds. And then, of course, in the sound recorder scene, he's there again. But here's time, I'm in the gold suit, sitting there going, etc. And of course, my coin face is sitting next to me and actually vaguely being tugged by fishing line to make him look slightly animated. We do that a lot in movies, I tell you. And it was only years later, that with the power of merchandising, white pointy face became a decipher card. Needed a name, white pointy face wouldn't really do. CZ3, easy peasy.
Easy peasy, lemon squeezy.
We have got Godfrey. Wow, there's a cat, not over yet. That was a fantastic story. I didn't know that until. That's fantastic.
Well, until I read it on the card.
Okay. We have. Okay, what about this? TomTom GPS. TomTom is a. Do you have it over here?
It's a navigation system.
It's for your car. Yes, it's a GPS thing. 3PO, yes. He's a nervous driver, I'm not sure.
I think we have some dialogue. Would you like to hear it?
In 400 Imperial yards, kindly go left at the roundabout. Take the fifth exit, if you please. I need a name for my lips. It is extraordinary because I actually have it in my car in France. And what is weird is he tells me in French words, and then literally I've heard him say, go left at the roundabout, take the fifth exit. And I'm actually so staring at the visual thing, how do you do that? Oh, you know, I missed the exit in time. I must admit, I now use the generic voice. There's times I want to get away from all this stuff.
Well, I can imagine, because there were some outtakes or something about it too, I believe, wasn't there?
The what?
There were some outtakes of that sometimes where he was a little less pleasant.
Really?
I think so. Let's take a listen.
Might I suggest you turn right? Wait a minute, you didn't turn! Hey, I just about had enough of you. You got us lost for sure, you incompetent. And I'm stuck inside this dashboard while you're having delusions you can drive!
And then it came out. That's the big ship. Yeah, here. Let's take a listen, shall we?
Oh, my star, I've never been so busy before. It seems Christmas arrives sooner each year. Christmas in the stars, what a merry Christmas this will be. Christmas in the stars, out among the stars, lighting up a Christmas tree. Come on everyone, let's sing.
You have selected envelope number two, the Force Awakens questions. I told you. Okay. Now, please know this. Please know that these are safe questions. Safe questions, and I assure you, they will not get you in trouble.
Wolves have ears.
these are safe questions.
Okay.
How did it feel to return to a galaxy far, far away?
What?
How did it feel to return to that galaxy far, far away?
Well, the curious thing is, actually, because I do so many shows like Clone Wars and Rebels and the wonderful Yoda Chronicles and all that kind of thing, that regularly I'm doing recordings in the sound studio. Myself without the gold suit on, and you know, I want to wear it obviously, but I'm going to fly it across the room. So I'm very used to being 3PO in other incarnations, and certainly in the Lego world of utter hilarity, where we just take somebody knows over here. Don't you love Lego? Yes! You know, I feel bad because I was rude to Will, so he can have a Lego C-3PO cube. Somebody like Ian Hare, you know, been there for a lot of years. Yeah. And the phone rang, and this female voice said something, and I carried on a conversation for about, or a monologue, for about 20, 30 seconds, until I said, I'm sorry, who did you say you are? And this voice said, I'm Kathy Kennedy, I'm the producer of the new Star Wars movies, and just wondering if it would be okay if J.J. Abrams gave you a call? How would you feel? I said yes. And we talked a lot, and it was very interesting because I came out of the sound studios doing things like Lego Clone Wars, and suddenly, and the sound studio is nothing, it's just a little box with a microphone, and suddenly I go onto the set at Pinewood, and I'm absolutely blown away. First of all, there's sets at all. Oh yeah, this is not. Who do people think this is? Anyway, the back of the hair is me.
That's you.
Do you want me? That's me there. Yeah. And Mark's looking a bit grumpy. Can you see? Mark, here we go. This was the read-through. Oh, that's great.
Cool. That is.
It's really good. So, but once we got out of there and we walked around the set, it was the real Star Wars. It felt absolutely like going back. How many years it was since Jedi? When was Jedi? 83. Okay. So it was a big. You know what? I was kidding when I said I couldn't tell you anything about Star Wars the next one. Yeah. What's it called? The Force Awakens. The Force Awakens.
Yes.
Did anybody see the trailer yesterday? To bring something other than a Lego keyring. Would anybody like to see the trailer again?
Thank you.
force another envelope on you.
Oh, wow. I'll take number 7.
Okay, this is the last envelope. Let's do this one. Let's see what happens.
How good was that trailer?
Number 7, entitled Questions from the Council. So this is where we open our questions up to the fans. So let's hear from you. Let's bring those lights up. Let's see if Elliot and Mark are out there. Do we have some questions from the fans?
Yeah, we got Lindsay's here. Lindsay. And I have another lady over here waving her hand.
Okay, Mark, why don't we go with you first then?
Yeah. Hi there. Come on over. Stand over here. Come on over. What's your name?
My name is Fernanda.
Fernanda.
Almost.
Oh, you say?
Yeah. Where are you? Oh, right.
She's over here.
Anthony, right
over
here.
Hi.
They're waving in the back here. Oh, you're over there. Stand up. Oh, sorry. Well, did you get that? Yes.
Hi. First, I want to say, as a fan, thank you. You're one of those people who love Star Wars, and every time we see you on anything, I think we can all agree that it's obvious you like Star Wars like we want, like Star Wars.
Thank you for being fans. The my favorite bit of, curiously, it's not to do with being in the films at all. It's when somebody comes up to me at an event like this and says, my kid won't believe that you're C-3PO. Well, why would he? I mean, look, do I look like C-3PO? Do I have a golden face? Do I have a beard? Yes. So the kid, the guy, and the kids would be really excited. Do you remember what 3PO sounded like? Mm-hmm. I mean, face it, this kid's being taught to not talk to strangers ever. And suddenly his father is introducing him to this weird guy who wears, or pretends to wear gold. So do you remember what he sounded like? Mm-hmm. Well, does he sound a bit like this? Hello. I am C-3PO, human cyberclinicians, and this is my counterpart, R2-D2. And then, what happens is, the physics of sound goes through his head, goes through the skull, and reaches that part of the brain that recognizes speech. And from looking totally like, you see this? For me, that is
check, check. Here we go.
You are standing. Go.
I'm here with Megan from Phoenix.
First of all, thank you for coming through the queue this morning. That started the day off and you had an excellent fun.
It's a great way for me to start the day. It actually gives me a boost to see all that huge enthusiasm. More of you next time in costumes, please. Please make something. Get a cardboard box, got a great costume. Yes, very good.
So my question is actually about the suit. You've mentioned a lot of times that the suit tends to chafe or hurt. Did they fix it for episode 7?
You don't want to know what Carrie said. You're okay. You're safe.
Yes, you know, she had that bikini on for a while. I think that changed.
That's right.
It's a heck of a lot more comfortable than mine. Oh, look, there's the bits. So here you have behind me a picture of everything you need to have to make. I can't believe it. To make a gold or whatever you wrote. All the bits in gold are very, very hard to get, very expensive. I, on the other hand, am always available and very, very cheap. I will tell you something that what JJ said to me on this phone call, would you just like to do the voice? And I said, no. And he said, quite right.
Look straight up, and way up top in the nosebleed section. Way up top. Over here, you see me? Way up top. What's your name, and what's your question?
Hello, Mr. Daniels.
Hello!
My name is Micah, and I have a two-part question. Yesterday, we were introduced personally to a new droid. I'm curious on what is your impression of this new droid, and what do you think C-3PO's reaction would be, say theoretically, if he was to meet that BB-8 droid?
All I can say is that is R2 there? BB-8 is adorable. He is magic, and the way it's created is beyond magic. It is absolutely stunning. It's really in all of the Star Wars creativity, I think that's almost the best thing I've ever seen. I cannot tell you any more than that. Shortly, of course, we'll be able to buy him in shops across Christmas. And you will, because it's magical. Eat your heart out, R2. Anyway. I didn't mean it. Look, I say cheap things just to get a reaction, to get a laugh, and most of you laughed. Most of you are on the dark side of it. Especially you, you're not very well lit together, right? But you see, if it wasn't, just stand up if you would. If it wasn't, If it wasn't for the original, we wouldn't have. Is it? Bear with me. If I may. What's your name?
Chris.
So you're not really R2-D2?
No.
Right, very good. Linus. And could you. Yeah. And could you do that sound again? What makes you go ooh like that? Serious, it's a serious audience.
Hey.
So, you've seen BB-8 on screen. You did it again. Yeah. You are R2-D2. What do you think of BB-8?
I think he's adorable.
Okay, is this droid love?
Well, there's a little bit of jealousy, but I still think he's adorable.
I think that's fair.
And that was the
Okay.
There are two kids out there.
But it's going to be more difficult because it's a ball. Can we do that? Can you have... Okay, thank you very much. We have one more, but I think you might want to sit down for this one. It's actually a video question. And why don't you look right at this
question from the console.
And let's take a look at this one. This is your next question. Or is it?
Ladies and gentlemen, you just called me at a quiet moment, surrounded by millions of fans, leafing through the Sith dictionary. I do this every evening because a word a day keeps the prudence at bay. And I've come across an entry under robots. Let me read it to you. Robots should only be used for completing dirty, dangerous, dull, or inaccessible tasks. If unable to restrain their humanoid tendencies in public, they are liable to explode. A great show, C-3PO.
So you feel the presence there?
Like I feel evil. That's been a good day. But you know something? Yesterday we started all this.
Well, happened? It was Celebration 6.
Yeah.
I was interviewing Ian and we were doing questions and somebody appeared up on the balcony and he never forgot it.
He's got a mean streak.
So,
not just on film. But
even I don't know what that means.
Yesterday, when they were announcing this brand new thing of having emoticons or whatever they're called for Twitter, there was one for a stormtrooper that was kind of cute, and there was one for something else in the middle. The whole, what do they call these feed things? I don't know.
Oh, the emoticons.
The hashtag things. And it came up with a very cute face of 3PO. And underneath it said, CP3O.
Yeah.
I mean, you'd think they'd get it right here. So rather cleverly, when I came on at the end, I mentioned the fact that that one of the greatest things of the day was to have finally, after 40 years in this saga, that I had become this Twitter thing, CP3O. How many people have tweeted, how come Anthony Daniels got his name wrong?
Very nice. Okay, this has been fun. Have you enjoyed yourself?
Oh, yes, huge.
Well,
have you enjoyed yourself?
So we have one last little video to look at. This is really just a way of saying thank you. So, take a look at the screen.
When you see Anthony Daniels put on his C-3PO outfit, I was standing next to you and he turned back. He turned and he said, it's like an icon here.
I was on set with C-3PO and it really took me back. I really remembered what it was like to be 6 or 7 and watching these films and felt excited about being in them, you know, now.
Here's 3PO. Now it is Star Wars. Star Wars has arrived. How do you do? My name is George. I'll be your director today.
The weird thing about 3PO, of course, is for the most part, he's completely out of his element in all the other movements. He's gone around saying,
Protocol? Why, it's my primary function, sir.
It's what I do, I translate. And he's had this terrible time because he's been put in fights and fires and mangled up and all sorts of weird creatures. 3PO has been the sort of, I think, fall guy or the funny guy throughout all these movies. And humor's been a big content of saga. I would just love to wear something that's and be comfortable in. And also to gesture in, to have free expression, to use my face, to use my hands, to use this kind of thing. but I don't, so I've had to make the most of it.
I need more emoting, I need more facial expression.
I think the one thing that really is coming down is tremendous affection for the character. For a character who's just benign, delightful, weird, sad, lonely. I think we'd all like to know.
Come on, Martin, we're going.